$5 for like six tomatoes.
Just out of Pisgah, we come across a farmer's market where I meet a local mushroom grower.
These I grow, this is a wild mushroom.
When I find out he takes people on tours and foraging, I take the opportunity to do something new.
All right, we'll see you then.
Okay,
thank
wonderful.
You very
thank
much.
Thank you.
I ate it. Yeah, it was at the neighbor's. The house across the street's a rental house.
The neighbor had a shovel in his hand. He says, I missed it with my shotgun. And he chopped the head off. And he had it on the shovel. I says, what you gonna do with it? And he says, I'm just gonna throw it in the woods. I said, no, it's lunchtime. I'm gonna eat that baby. We're gonna tour my farm. And I'm gonna show you all the different ways that I grow my mushrooms. My whole goal is to grow numerous varieties of mushrooms, but not in the quantities. Right now I'm growing approximately 50 to 75 pounds of shiitake mushrooms a week. I'm a grower of mushrooms first and a forager second, but I have to learn how the mushrooms grow in the wild in order to duplicate that so I can try and cultivate them. They grow naturally on stumps, and so in order to cultivate this mushroom, I take short pieces of oak wood and I put the spores to it and bury it to make it think it's a stump. Don't mind the spiders. One thing mushroom farming has done for me is taught me patience, because anything I do is at least 6 months to the year down the road that I'll see fruit. I'll take my logs. This is the next stack I'll be soaking for this next week.
Is this shiitake?
Yes, these are all shiitakes.
Our tour takes about 2 hours, and Greg gives a lot of great information on all the varieties he grows. Then what I look forward to most, mushroom hunting in the forest, his big backyard.
So we go into the woods to collect wild mushrooms, and you have to have a basket. You also get the handy dandy, you know what you're doing, mushroom hunting tool designed by me. So you can look underneath the mushroom to see if it's got gills, teeth, or pores, and then you can cut the mushroom, and if it's really dirty, you can brush the dirt off. And if it's really dirty, you can give a little scrub-a-dub-dub. And then if you get lost in the woods, you can use it as a signaling mirror, and when your teeth get really gross, you can brush your teeth. You're gonna start seeing a lot of different mushrooms. In the national forest, you're allowed to pick 1 pound per mushroom species per person. For personal consumption. I am not allowed to collect mushrooms on the Forest Service for resale. As long as you're not removing the log or digging the dirt up, you should be able to go back to these areas every year at approximately the same time to collect those good edible mushrooms. So that's why people are very secretive of their spots. Can you smell the little bit of fishy smell on your fingers?
Yeah.
Here is an example of the sickening ruchula. This one is not edible, but all ruchulas, the stem will crack like a piece of chalk.
What about that?
Okay, this is an Amanita. Amanitas are your worst enemies.
Oh.
These are the most poisonous of all the mushrooms. Just one little bit will kill you dead. Never eat an ammonite. Never.
What about this?
That we fondly refer to as an LBM. Little brown mushroom.
Every fun guy needs a rope swing. That's a huge beefsteak.
Look at that. Is that not a beauty? Look at that.
Wow.
That is a prime.
I'm excited to try these.
I must confess that I've never been a big fan of mushrooms. But this experience changes that. For this last part of my visit, it's mushroom tasting time.
It's like crispier than chanterelles. It's almost like a potato chip or something.
This is the beefsteak mushroom. And it's the only one you can eat raw safely, but if you break it on open, look at how it's marbled. Like, chefs will cut it really thin and wrap. They use it as called the sushi of the wood, so try that. It's got a tangy, citrusy almost.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very unique. You know, I've been doing this for many years and it still just fascinates me and impresses me when I do this. I pull my revolver from my side. I destroyed that poor boy's soul.
Why do you like this job or what you do here so much?
I used to work in the four walls as a factory worker. Now I stay outside all the time. If I'm not growing my mushrooms in my backyard, I go into my big backyard and I'm hunting mushrooms. It just lends, and it's all new to me. There's just so much to learn. No one person could never know it all. And I am just daily fascinated with the different aspects of mushrooms. Even just uncovering a batch of mushroom logs. After doing it for 12 years, it still takes my breath away, the beauty of the mushrooms themselves. I am the fungi, the mushroom man, and I like having that classification, that designation. So put